Hello. Welcome to RandoMixer introductory tutorial. Here we have a simple scene with some objects, representing part of an interior. Suppose we want to try different ways to arrange these elements. We will use RandoMixer to quickly generate and visualize some possible variants. The plugin has the following rollouts. They are all disabled by default, except for the first one, which is for general management. Sets elements, where you load the objects you want to work with. The next three rollouts are used to perform specific operations on the objects, lights, cameras and materials. Create Manage Collection rollout is the most important one. It's where you build and edit a collection of variants or states for your objects. Then there are general utilities. Some of them are simplified independent versions of other tools. And a help rollout, with links to documentation and tutorials. To start using the plugin, you need to create a master icon. This helper stores all the plugin's data and also displays some useful information. It's always better to hide it, to avoid deleting it accidentally. This is a list of presets to quickly set parameters for a specific purpose. You can also create and save your own presets. Let's start playing with these objects. We want to swap them around and see how the scene looks. So let's begin by selecting these three plants and loading them into the plugin. Now we go to Switch Places section. Activate the function and leave all settings by default. Go down to Create Manage Collection and just press Create Collection. A collection of 6 variants is created. You can navigate it with these yellow arrows and see the changes. The plants are switching places now. But since the pivot is not at the base, they are either floating or under the ground. We can fix this by changing the anchor point setting to base. Now it works correctly. The plugin created 6 variants because that is the maximum number of combinations possible in this case. Let's make it a bit more interesting by changing the number of elements that are visible each time to a minimum of 1 and a maximum of 3. This is done here at the Set Properties dialog. This time the plugin created 10 possible variants. This button shows or hides all objects. Let's clear all the elements from the list. If you have nothing selected, it lets you pick objects by name. Let's load now all objects. When you load a group, like the stack of magazines, the plugin gives you the option to treat it as a single entity or as separate elements. I will eliminate from the list some of these objects. Let's change some parameters to make all these elements switch places. Now I want to get 20 variants. This looks nice. Let's play a bit more by varying the number of elements. Sometimes you need to delete the collection to restart all elements to their initial position. Now we can try having more than one set of elements. Let's change the method to multiple sets. You can see there are two lists now. The list of elements moved down and there's a list of sets above. The controls work in a very similar way. We will add a new set with the two groups of pictures that are on the wall. Let's change the set names to identify them better. If you select a set on the list, you will see its elements below. Let's change the number of elements for this set to a minimum of 1 and a maximum of 2. And exclude it from the switch places action. That's all for this first tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it. See you in the next one.